I was still continuing my job as a manager candidate and a licensed financial advisor in one of the biggest insurance companies in the Philippines, and to promote for better healthcare systems and education. Because this is the war that we've been fighting for, and our conflicts has turned to this, and racism, and war on hunger. So these are the causes that I want to respond to.
Okay, so being a
top-up
is the biggest possibility for me also, and then that's why I have a big platform to promote epilepsy. That's why we made the applications called Aura Epilepsy and make people more aware of it. And I will work hard on it because now it's only available in App Store, but we will work on making it available in Play Store. So all people will have the Aura app to hop around because I have big experience with my family. Oh my god. Because my niece is passing away with epilepsy. That's why like I really want to work hard on it. And then I don't want to lose anything at all. Like I don't want to lose someone again. That's why like now I'm focusing on Aura apps.
For me, I have a project called Twins for Good. We don't have only one call, but it helps everyone that's in need, like people in the streets, people that are in hospitals. I'm a medical student, so I ask my teachers so we can do free consults for people that need. And also I'm joining a part of the home that helps women with cancer. I'm planning, because I work with plastic surgeons as well, I'm planning to expand my project so I can help the women that have to take their breast tissue purchases. So this is basically what I'm doing. I think we all have like big and strong causes. There are many things to do in the world, many things that we can help. But at least if we help one person, it's like at least one person that it's been helped. So the main purpose is always helping each other.
Mm-hmm. Is there someone that you stay in Thailand since you have to be quarantined, right?
Yeah.
How do you feel this is the part of life that you being aboard and have to have contest and also to be face with coronavirus?
For me, it's not a problem at all to be abroad. I really like Thailand. I've lived here in the past. This is my third time here. My second time, I was for 3 months working as a model. And the goodest thing, like here, I feel there is no pandemic going on in my country. Everything's closed. We're in lockdown. More than 3,000 people are dying every day. And here, I just feel like I'm living in a dream, you know, because everyone is happy. No one's getting sick. So it's not a problem at all. I love the food, I love the energy. Wow. That's why I'm pretending to stay more. I wish you could stay with my cream a little bit more.
Okay. How about you?
And with me, I actually really love Thailand. As I said, Thailand is just like home. My second home. And it's like I love the weather, I love the food, I love the culture. But what's most important is that all of us girls, when we come in here, we came in with a mindset to stay. Because we knew that any one of us could win, and whoever would win, this would become our home for next year. So we psyched our mind and prepared our mind. Walking into the country and realizing that the government has done such a good job in keeping the country safe and keeping the cases really low and making sure that everybody's forced to quarantine for 14 days makes me feel very safe. Like, I don't have a problem with when I'm going out and I don't even wear my mask. I'm not as scared as I would be if I am going to be back in the United States. So I really commend the government on that, and I really commend everybody here in Thailand for taking these safe measures to make all of us feel safe and happy.
And what happened? I had a different speak time. And how are you passing?
How did I learn? So when I was coming here to Thailand, I knew that there was a possibility that I might stay. So I did get a Thai teacher. She actually lives here. She's in the university. And we practice online. So every day, 1 hour per day. And that's how I started to learn my Thai. I have a flashcard, so I learn like 50 words per day as well. So I write them on the flashcard, and wherever I go, I take 50 and I keep practicing.
What about a new sentence that you practice?
Oh, okay. So I know how to say a lot of things actually. It just, I just have to communicate. I can say, sabai di mai ka, sabai di shen dan. Shanshi Wabina, Kunshi Oraika, and like I can have a conversation with you. You just have to talk slow, quick chat chat, so that I can understand.
Can you still remember the speech that you said in on the stage?
On the stage, yes. Okay, so my speech is Pokrao Achimi Sakshana, Kuatsana Sang, Ru Sipu, T. Sekshanjan, Se Pokrao Luan, Muan Dan Pai Nai, Tung Wila Leo, Si Pokrao Sukon, Kuan Dai Rasin, Legan Basbat, Yang Tao Siam Gan, Yamua Rovila, Ru Rokon Kuni, Gan Chiang Lang 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 Dai, Jack Kune.
Okay, so I have a hard topic about Myanmar. I mean, today she will have conference, I think. So, what do you want to say to her about her situation right now?
I first of all want to commend her for her bravery. She is being so brave, and right now she's like the voice of her country. And I think we all have to give and take a bit from Myanmar and stand up for things that are happening. As I said, we are spokespersons. If we sit down and do nothing, then nothing will happen. But if we get up and speak and create awareness, the world will be forced to listen to us. And Myanmar is doing that for their people. And I believe that we should try and protect her as much as possible. I'm so glad that the Miss Grand International Organization is actually reaching hands and protecting her this far. I'm very grateful for that. I believe that we all are entitled to a bit of democracy. We all need a government that is for the people, by the people, and with the people. That's the most important. Because we all have to come together to make a decision for the country because it benefits all of us. So I believe that together is how we can make the world a better place.
What about you, too, what you want to say to yourself? Because you are in Iceland or so, you have like
friends.
Yes, I mean, you want to say something to you.
Yeah, so the journey has not been ended. We are still supporting Miss Grand International and all of the people that supports us, especially with Save Myanmar. With our, she's been traveling a lot as well. She's been working so hard for her country. And I think if her voice can amplify more voices, and I hope that it could create a case of change for our society. And we stand by her to save democracy and save Myanmar. And for all our fans, please keep supporting Miss Grand International. And you can follow us on our social media pages at Ken TV and Miss Grand International page. Maraming salamat.
So for me, I will say to Han that you are the brave girl we have to. We will stay behind her back and we will never be alone because you are the brave girl. You survive from everything that happened in your country and you come here using your voice. It's such an amazing girl and I'm really proud to be your friend, to be your sister.
What about you? Can you say something to your friend?
Yeah, of course. She's being very courageous. She's facing a very hard situation in her country. I really admire her for what she did. She had the courage to go to speak for everybody and it's our duty to support her. It's not because it's not our country, but we have to defend our word. We are only one. We have to work together. We will be always here supporting her. And Miss Grand International Organization, we are giving her a big support. And she's going to have big opportunities here. I just want to say that we are going to stop.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. Ha. Ha.
She has not to look to the camera.
She was like, and I'm like, no, she has to just not look to the camera.
Yeah, and maybe just more or do something at a swimming.
done for our first interview here at Bay 3. So come and watch us later. Kaba!
Oh, yeah. Ivana is our sister. Yeah, unfortunately, she could not make it today because she hurt her ankle and she really needs to rest because it's been like 1 week that she.
No, more than three weeks, I guess. Yeah. It's after the swimsuit competition that she broke her ankle, but she endured all the pain until after this day, so we decided, like, just rest, and then even Mr. Yes and Mr. Namad told her to just rest today. So don't worry about her. Yeah. She's doing a lot of precautions and she's been meeting all the doctors, and also her parents are here, so they will bond today and taking care of her in the room. So that's it, guys, for today. See you later.